Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 78 of our Golang course. In this lesson, we will look at how to prevent goroutine leaks. So let's get started. We know that goroutines are easy to create and are really cheap. The go runtime takes care of executing the goroutines. Goroutines have a memory footprint and take resources, and the go garbage collector doesn't clean up after unused goroutines, which means they must terminate on their own. So if you have a goroutine that you didn't terminate properly, it will continue to execute in the background or take resources like memory and CPU from your main program. So it should be the responsibility of the creator of the goroutine to terminate unused goroutines. Let's now look at termination paths for a goroutine. The following three paths should help you identify how and when to terminate a goroutine in your program. The first is when the job assigned to a goroutine is completed. Then the second is that there was an error when the goroutine was executed. Then the third and final termination path is when the parent goroutine that created the child goroutine needs to terminate the child goroutine. Here, the first two cases are easy to handle. If the work is complete, the goroutine itself can return, thus freeing up resources. Similarly, it can also return when there is an error during its execution. The third is the case that we should pay more attention to. The goroutine responsible for creating a goroutine is also responsible for ensuring that it can stop the goroutine that it created. Now, this relates to something that I have talked about in the last lesson, which is the done channel. It is better understood with code examples. So let us look at some of the examples of using a done channel to terminate your goroutines. First, I'm going to create a function, somework, that starts a goroutine to do some work, exactly what the name suggests. To make sure that somework completes, we are going to use sync.waitGroup. Somework is going to return a channel that the creator of somework can listen to for outputs. As you can see, it is going to be a read-only channel. Inside somework, let us first create the channel. Now we are going to start a goroutine to write something on channel. Inside it, first I'm going to defer the call of workgroup.done. Then I'm just going to try and write to the channel. I'm just going to write a fmt.println statement that prints when the goroutine is completed. Inside it, I'm just going to say goroutine finished. Finally, from some work, we are going to return the channel we are writing to. Now, in our main function, first we are going to create a wait group. Then I'm going to call some work, but before calling some work, let us add one to the wait group. This is because we are only creating one goroutine from the main goroutine. Now let us pass the wait group. Then let us wait for the execution of the goroutine created in some work. This will be done by waitgroup.wait. Now this is our program to demo a leaking goroutine. As you can see, in some work, first we create a channel, which is an int channel. Then we start a goroutine to write on to the int channel, then return the channel. In the main function, we are calling some work, but we are not listening to the channel returned by some work for any data. This means that this goroutine will try to write to a channel that is not being listened to, which you know is a blocking call. So we will never complete the execution of our main function, because this goroutine is hanging, trying to write the value to the channel. Run our program, go run main.go, and as you can see, we are getting deadlocks. If I remove this, and suppose this was a long running program that didn't exit when the main is completed, for example, a server. This means during the execution of the program, our goroutine created in some work will continue to occupy resources. Let me put the statement back. Now, to handle any goroutine leak, as I mentioned, we use a done channel. So we will update some work to accept the done channel. Usually by convention, the done channel is a channel that accepts a empty struct values and is the first argument to a function. So here, some work is now accepting a done channel. Inside the goroutine, what we are going to do is create a select statement. Inside select, one of the cases is writing to the channel. Then another case is listening to the done channel. So with this statement, what we are saying is that when select statement is blocked, it will unblock when either we are able to write to channel or if there's a value on done or done is closed. Now here, let's create the done channel, make channel of struct, and then pass it as the first argument to some work. Now that's all our setup. So we are calling some work with done and the wait group. Now we are going to wait for a few seconds, let's say 1 second, to see if some work can execute what it was assigned to. Otherwise, we're just going to close the done channel to indicate that the coroutine should terminate. Now let's run our program to see what happens. And as you can see, we almost waited for 1 second and then we closed the done channel, which indicated to some work that it should unblock, doesn't matter if it was able to write to channel 1 or not. And finally, we got our goroutine finished statement printed to the console. This way, the creator of the goroutine, which is our main goroutine, was able to terminate the child goroutine when it needed to. In this way, you ensure that the goroutine that you created is always terminated correctly, freeing up any resources that it may be occupying. We learned that the creator of a goroutine should be responsible for cleaning up after the goroutines that it creates. Then we looked at the done channel pattern, which is an effective way to terminate goroutines from the parent goroutine or the creator of the goroutines in case where the child goroutine is taking unexpected time to complete the job. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding.